That's an FDL3. Sort of, not quite. This is a bit of a special case. It's a little bit unique in that this particular FDL has got a Narfduino control system in it, and it's using Brotherhobby R6 motors instead of the usual sort of fare. The flywheel geometry is a little bit different too. Because it's got a different control system, I've gone for a different screen setup. It's a little bit larger than the one that comes as standard. Buttons are up the top as opposed to the side. Okay. One big difference here is that I was able to put a magazine switch in there, and consequently this has got an ammo counter built into the screen. What we can see, no magazine. Darts in this magazine. We have three buttons across the top and the rotary button here. Each of these has two functions. You hold it, you press it for a short period of time and it will execute one function. If you press it for a long period of time, it'll execute a different function. Each of those can be remapped with one exception. So the short button press for the rotary will always go into the configuration screen. But the long button press can be remapped along with all of these. So currently, the long button press is to set this into safe mode, and you can see that it's currently in safe. And we've got single shot, burst shot, full auto. And there we go, it's in safe. If you press the short button, we can go into the menu where we can configure all the different options. First is the power setting for the motor. We can adjust the rate of fire for the full auto select fire setting. We can also change the rate of fire for the burst shots as well. So you can have different rates of fire depending upon what's going on. You can change the burst size. So currently there's two, but it can go anywhere up to whatever you want. Magazine is currently set to 12. And what we can do with this one is we can drop it all the way down. When it gets to this up, it will count up from zero instead of counting down from whatever number you set. We've got some motor ramping configurations, so the rate of change on the motors. You've also got some dwell settings as well, so how long the motors are going to sit there at full performance before and after the firing sequence. And this is where you can remap the buttons. So in this case here, we've got the left hand button here for the short function. What we can do, we can remap that to burst or auto or safe mode, or change the profile A or profile B, or null for nothing. So I'll just keep that as single shot. And we can go through and change all of those. It'll automatically save. So it has two profiles. Each of the profiles can have all of those settings set up separately, so you can have different button maps depending upon the profiles, or you can have different rates of fire. You could have a high speed and a low speed, because this is a single trigger system, you can't have a high low trigger, and away it goes. So currently it's in safe mode, as you can see. Nothing happens. We can go into single shot mode. This is at 50%. We just fired off six shots. Go into burst mode. And then auto. And that is an Arduino powered FDL3. Magazine dropped.